Hello dear students, welcome back to this session. In this session, we shall discuss about what are the factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. In last session, we already discussed about all these things, but in this session, we shall discuss it briefly. What are the factors affecting the resistance of a conductor? First factor is length of the conductor. Second factor is area of a cross section. Area of a cross section of a conductor. This is the length of the conductor. Third one is material of the conductor. What are the materials? What type of material is that conductor? That is the third factor. Fourth one is temperature in conductor. How much temperature contains that conductor? These are the factors which affect the resistance of the conductor. So we shall discuss it briefly one by one. First is length of a conductor. When we increase the length of the conductor, then resistance will automatically increase. So resistance is directly proportional to length of the conductor. If you increase the length of the conductor, the resistance automatically increases. So, if you double the length of the conductor, to equivalent that conductor, we have to use two conductors which connect in a series. Let this conductor, assume that this conductor having length is 20 ohm. So we have to use two conductor which are connected in a series, that is having 10 ohm and 10 ohm. So we have to connect these two resistance to equivalent that resistance, which is doubled. So this is we have to connect it in series to equivalent. So the sum of the resistance of the conductor is equivalent to the given conductor. So when the length of the conductor increases, the resistance automatically increases. They are directly proportional with each other. Similarly, second factor is area of a cross section. This is the area or thickness of the conductor. If thickness or area of the conductor always inversely proportional with the resistance. If the area or thickness of the conductor get halved, the resistance will double and vice versa. So here R is inversely proportional to area of a cross section. They are inversely proportional with each other. When resistance is doubled, then the area of cross section get halved. And if area is doubled, then resistance will get doubled. It halved, it doubled. If it is doubled, it gets halved. So they are inversely proportional with each other. So thickness of the conductor, if increases, then the resistance will decreases. If it is increases, the area of cross section automatically It is, if it is increases, area of cross section is increases, the resistance get decreases because they are inversely proportional. Area of the Ouchy cross section or the diameter. Diameter of a Ouchy conductor is always resistance always square of its diameter, inversely proportional to square of its diameter. Resistance of a conductor always the square of inversely proportional to square of its diameter. When suppose the resistance is 2 ohm, so its diameter will be 4. If it is 2 ohm, then its diameter will be 4 square meter. So they are inversely proportional with each other. So in this area of cross section, this is the factor when the thickness or area of cross section increases, then resistance decreases. If the resistance decreases, then freely flow of electrons or charges will pass through the conductor. Electrons or current freely flow through the conductor. So in a thick wire, in compared to the thin wire, thick wire, which in thick wire, current freely flow through the conductor. But in thin wire, if the area of cross section is less, then its resistance will be more. The area of cross section, if it decreases, then which resistance will be more. So current, this conductor does not allow the current freely flow through the conductor, freely flow through it. So always, if length of the wire increases, the resistance which always increases. So the area of a cross section, if it increases, then which resistance decreases. So we are conclude here that the thin wire, the thick wire, and medium length, and thick wire having less resistance. And similarly, thin wire and long wire having more resistance. Here we are conclude that in thick wire and less length of the wire, that wire allow the current freely flow through it. But the length, the conductor having less length, more length, and thin area, that conductor does not allow more current flow through the conductor freely. This is the difference in between the length of the conductor and area of cross section of the conductor or thickness of the conductor. So here we know that when thickness of a conductor is increases, then its resistance get decreases. So we have to, if it is 20 ohm, we have to take two wire having 10 ohm and 10 ohm and connect it into parallelly. Parallel connection, we have to take it parallel. If the conductor is 20 ohm, we have to equivalent this wire, we have to use two wire which connected in parallel, and this would say the resultant conduct, the resistance of the resultant resistance of each conductor is half of that conductor, given conductor. So this is all about the resistance, the area of cross section affecting the resistance of the conductor and length affecting the length resistance of the conductor. Then the material affecting, material affecting the resistance of the conductor. Different materials having different resistances. Suppose the resistance of a pure metal and the resistance of an alloy. The resistance of alloy is 60 times is more than the pure metal, resistance of a pure metal. It is, by doing different experiment, it is proved that a nichrome wire having the resistance of a nichrome wire is 60 times more than that of the copper metal. So nichrome metal, nichrome is which alloy, not metal, nichrome is alloy, and its resistance is 60 times more than the copper metal. So the materials affecting the resistance of the conductor. Different materials having different resistance. So different alloys having more resistance and than the pure metals. Then the temperature. Then the temperature affecting the resistance of the conductor. When the temperature increases, the resistance also increases. The less resistance having less, the less temperature, lower the temperature, the resistance will lower. And if the temperature increased, then the resistance will automatically increased. So the temperature also directly proportional to the resistance. If temperature increasing of temperature is directly proportional to increasing the resistance of resistance of the conductor. So when resistance is when temperature is increased, then the resistance also increases. So these are the different factors affecting the resistance of the conductor. Then we shall discuss about what is the resistivity of the conductor. Resistivity. Resistivity of the conductor. Then we already discussed about the R is directly proportional to L. Resistance is directly proportional to length of the wire. Similarly, the resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. This is the first equation left, and this is the second equation. By combining the two equations, R is directly proportional to L by A. If we omit that proportional sign, and instead of that we use equal sign, then one constant term will multiply to L by A. So here R is equal to this constant term, the rho into L by A. Then R is equal to rho into L by A. This is rho. rho, and this rho is known as, this constant is known as resistivity of that conductor or specific resistance of the conductor. So here rho is constant, and this constant is known as resistivity of the conductor or specific resistance of the conductor. So here R is equal to rho into L by A, or rho is equal to how much? R into A divided by L. Then what is resistivity? Different conductors having different resistance, that is known as resistivity of the conductor. Different materials, different conductor having different resistances, that is known as resistivity of the conductor. So here, when the area of a cross section of a wire, if area of a cross section of a wire is 1 square meter and the length of the conductor is 1 meter, then the how much we will get? Rho is equal to R into 1 meter square divided by rho into 1 meter square. Rho means resistance, means ohm. We are using here the unit of that substances, the resistor and area of cross section and length of the wire. Here the unit of resistance is ohm into, that is 1 meter, area of the conductor is 1 square meter and length of the conductor is 1 meter. So that is meter. So we are getting here 1 ohm meter. When area of a cross section of a single, a definite wire, a conductor is 1 square meter and the length of the conductor is 1 meter, then the rho is equal to R. Here rho is directly proportional to also resistance, specific resistance. Resistance is directly proportional to specific resistance. If which resistance is doubled, then which specific resistance automatically doubled. It is halved, then it will be halved. Directly proportional. So here, what is resistivity? Now here rho is equal to R. If which A is equal to 1 square meter and which is 1 meter, then which rho is equal to R. So here's different elements, different which materials having different resistivity. So here we are which by different experiment, it is concluded that different material means silver is, that is 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁸ ohm meter, the resistivity of that conductor. That means that is when the area of silver metal is 1 square meter and the length of silver metal is 1 meter, then the resistance of that silver metal is 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁸. Resistivity of that conductor, resistance of that conductor is 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁸ meter ohm. So that is also known as 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁸ ohm, the resistivity of that conductor. Similarly, the copper having 1.69 × 10⁻¹⁸ ohm meter, the resistivity of the conductor. When the length of the copper is 1 meter and the area of a cross section of that copper is 1 square meter, then the resistance of that copper metal is 1.69 × 10⁻¹⁸ meter. So here we can do different problems relating to this resistance and specific resistance. If you resistance is given, length of the wire is given, and area of cross section is given, we can find out the rho and also different hocchi terms we can hocchi no if a r is given rho is given a is given we can find out length of the wire similarly area of cross section of the wire similarly resistance of the wire specific resistance of the wire all these things we can hocchi solve by different hocchi exam problems when asked in examination thank you all